Good morning, students. So today, after completion of exercise 3.2, we are proceeding further for the next topic. The topic is transpose of a matrix. So what is a transpose of a matrix? Let's understand. Let A equals to Aij of m by n order be any matrix, then the transpose of this matrix A is obtained by interchanging the rows and columns of the matrix A is called the transpose of A. It means if we are given a matrix A, that is Aij m by n, and if we change its rows and columns, that is rows into columns or columns into rows, then the matrix obtained is called as transpose of that matrix. And further, it is denoted by A dash or A to the power T. Okay, so we can use any notation, A dash or A to the power T, that is A transpose, right? So let's consider one example. Let's take a matrix A, 1 2 3 4 5 6, okay, any matrix, and the order is 2 by 3. Now let's find its transpose or A dash. So according to the definition, we have to change rows into columns. So see, this is the first row, so this first row has to be changed in columns. So write at the first column place, so 1 2 3, that is row 1 is converting now into column first. Similarly, the second row is 4 5 6, so this second row is going to be converted in second column, so we'll write here 4 5 6. So now this matrix is the transpose of this given matrix, okay, that is A dash equals to 1 2 3 or 4 5 6. Now let's find the order. What is the order of this matrix? 1 2 3 3 rows and 2 columns, so order is 3 by 2. It means it is observed that this was the order of given matrix 2 by 3, and after transpose the order gets reversed, that is 3 by 2. Okay, it means while we find transpose of any matrix, then the order gets reversed, that is rows converted into columns, and the columns, that is 3, converted into rows, 3 by 2. So I think the concept is clear. Transpose is nothing, only the interchanging of rows into columns. Now let's see the next topic, properties of transpose of a matrix. So what are the properties? So let's consider two matrices A and B of suitable order. I mean, it may be of any order, 1 by 2, 2 by 3, etc. Then we have the following assumptions, following rules, which are evidently verified and we will verify in the exercise problem. So see the first property, A transpose then whole transpose equals to A. So according to this property, if we find the two times, that is double transpose of the matrix, so we get the same matrix. So let us verify by taking one example over here. So let's take A equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, be any matrix. Now find its, this implies A transpose. So what we do in transpose? We change row into column. So first row, that is 1, 2, is converting now into first column, 1, 2. Similarly, 3, 4, second row converted into second column. Now again, if we find its transpose, A transpose, then transpose. So again, we have to change this row into columns. So change 1, 3 and second row 2, 4. Will come here. Okay. Now what we see? Check, this is what your given matrix A. So what we have seen, the transpose of the matrix of transpose itself the matrix, I mean double time transpose gives the same matrix, okay, hence 2. Okay students, clear? So this was the property first, transpose of a transpose of matrix itself, the matrix. Now second property is what? If the matrix is multiplied by K, K is what? Any constant, any scalar. Okay. So this will give K as it is, and this transpose will come over the matrix A. It means constant is what? Unaffected while we do transposing of the matrix. Property third, A plus B, sum of the matrices, then transpose gives, distribute over all the matrices. Same as it happens in minus sign. If the negative sign, so it will operated on both. Now fourth property or important property, A into B product of matrices dash equals to, dash means transpose, gives what? B transpose into A transpose. It means, it is noted that here the order of A into B is changed into B into A, and the transpose operated on both. Like exponent law, but in exponent law order was changing or not changing doesn't impact, but in matrix there is a great impact, there is a great change. Okay, so the order must be reversed. Make sure if there is A into B, so this will be B into A and transpose on both the matrix, right? So the next topic is a very important topic, 3 marks question asked many times in board exams, symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. So these are special type of matrices. So let's see. Symmetric matrix, I square matrix, it is to be noted that for symmetric matrix the matrix must be what? A square matrix, not any matrix. The concept is applied only on square matrix. So a square matrix, that is A, equals to Aij of order n. You can take any order, 2 order, 1, 3, 4. So we can write only n or n by n, right? It is understood. Is said to be symmetric if A dash equals to A. A dash equals to A. A dash means what? Transpose, what we previously studied in the previous article. A dash equals to A, that is Aji. Okay, suppose Ji, this is an arbitrary element, compact notation of the matrix, converted into Aij, that is Ji changed in Ij, because row converted into columns for all possible values of I and J. So let's verify this thing with the examples. Consider any matrix A, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6, 3, 6, 7, something. Now let's find its A transpose. So 1, 2, 3, this is the row first. So we will write here in column first, 1, 2, 3, next 2, 4, 6, second row. So second column, 2, 4, 6. Similarly, 3, 6, 7, third row becomes 3, 6, 7, third column. Okay, so now what we see, check. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, 3, 6, 7. So it means what we have seen, it is what? Equals to A. It means the given matrix is what? Symmetric matrix. So it is not necessary that every time it is going to be equal to itself. That is transpose of the matrix equal to A. It happens only in a case of if the matrix is symmetric. So in order to verify any matrix is symmetric matrix, we just need to find A transpose, and if we get the same matrix, that is the given matrix, it means the matrix is symmetric matrix. Okay, clear? Next point, is skew symmetric matrix. So again let's consider any square matrix. A equals to Aij of order n is said to be skew symmetric matrix if A dash equals to minus A. So this time what is the change as compared to symmetric matrix? Only minus sign is coming. And previously we have seen A dash equals to A for symmetric matrix, and for skew symmetric A dash equals to minus A. It means if the order of this matrix is Aji, suppose, then the order of this matrix must be Aij, because in dash the order gets reversed. So Ji becomes Ij. So minus sign is here. Now on taking I equals to J, this is what particularly one topic that we want to get one result or deduction from this result. So I equals to J, then what happens? A, J, in place of J, we are writing I. This is I. Okay. I equals to minus A, I. That is, we are replacing J by I. Now, transfer this, transposing this to left hand side. Minus becomes plus. AII equals to 0. The same terms if we add, 2 times of AII equals to 0. And then this gives AII equals to 0. Okay, that is 2 will be going in 0 by 2 for all i's. It means AII equals to 0 means what? II means same numbers, right? We can say if we take I equal to 1, A11. If we take I equals to 2, then A22, A33. So you must observe and you must have seen that A11, A22, A33 are the elements none other than diagonal elements. Okay, 11, 22, 33, these elements coming into where? Diagonal place. Okay, so it means we can observe all the diagonal elements are 0 in skew symmetric matrix. One more question also can be asked in skew symmetric matrix, what are the values of diagonal elements? What is the specific values of diagonal elements? So you will write answer 0. That diagonal elements are 0 in skew symmetric matrix. So let's consider one example of this. Example A goes to, let's consider this matrix 0, 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 3, minus 2, minus 3, 0. This is what I have taken the particular matrix, okay, which proves symmetric, skew symmetric matrix, right? So let's find A transpose. What we do? Transpose of matrix, the very first article of today's lecture, change this row into column 0, 1, 2. Similarly, my second row, this is second row, and writing into second column place 0, 3, and this is third row, so third column. Okay, first row, first column, second row, second column, third row, third column. That is what? Transpose of the matrix. Now take minus common. If we take minus common, then what happens? See, 0, 0, that is minus 0 means 0, 1, 2, similarly this will be minus 1, minus 0 means 0, we are writing only 0, okay, and minus 3 gives 3 only, and same as minus 2, then minus 3 or 0. Now minus, what I have written, see A, Y, check this matrix is what? Using first you can say, are they same or not? 0, 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 3, minus 2, minus 3, 0. So it means what we have got? A dash equals to minus A. So we have proved A dash equal to minus A. It means the given matrix is skew symmetric matrix. If A dash not equals to minus A, it means the matrix is not skew symmetric matrix. Okay, and we have also seen what the diagonal elements A11, A22, A33 are 0 only. This happens only in a case of whenever the principal diagonal or diagonal elements are 0. So you can try to find out such matrix which is skew but 0 is not coming. You can try. And I am sure you won't find any matrix. Okay, if you find, then you just send me that matrix. Okay. So it was about skew symmetry. Now we are going to learn some important theorems results which will be used in the questions. Theorem first. For any square matrix A, make sure we are taking square matrix. For any square matrix A with real number entries or real numbers, then A plus A dash is a symmetric matrix. This is the most important result. If A is what? Square matrix. And if we add A plus its transpose into it, then we get a result. What? Symmetric matrix. And similarly, if A minus A dash we do, then we get what? Skew symmetric matrix. Okay, so this is what the theorem if we add transpose to the given matrix, we get symmetric matrix, and if we subtract the transpose of the matrix from the given matrix, then we get skew symmetric matrix. So now the theorem second related to this, any square matrix can be expressed as the sum of what? Sum of symmetric matrix and skew symmetric matrix. It means any square matrix, you can take any square matrix, that can be written expressed as sum of symmetric and skew symmetric. So let us write it mathematically. So let A be any square matrix, then this can be expressed as A equals to 1 by 2 A plus A transpose plus 1 by 2 A minus A transpose. This is the mathematical result. Okay, 1 by 2 A plus A transpose plus 1 by 2 A minus A transpose. If you simplify this, let us simplify, what we get? A plus A dash plus A minus A dash, taking LCM, right? So A dash cancel. So 2A by 2, that is 2 or 2 cancel A, which means left hand side, that is A. It means mathematically the sum of these matrices equal to this. Now let's see, A plus A dash is what? As per previous theorem, this is symmetric matrix, and A minus A dash is what? Skew symmetric matrix, and this is what? Plus. So now we have put sum of symmetric and skew symmetric. One more thing is there, 1 by 2 is coming. So can this any constant or 1 by 2 affect symmetric matrix? No, not at all. If you multiply any symmetric matrix by any constant, the result remains same. You can practically verify by taking any examples, and we will do in fact in the exercise problem. Okay, so it's all about today's lecture. I mean, we have finished all the articles of the chapters. Now you will do the examples of the same exercise, I mean 3.3, and if exercise problems, okay, this is your homework, and you will ask your queries. Okay, so I hope you understood. So do example first, then exercise problem. Thank you.